This is the Besotted Pride of West London podcast, coming to you from New Griffin Park at the end of the game where sometimes I say it didn't go according to plan. This game absolutely and totally didn't go according to plan. I'm looking around me looking for people to talk to, and to be honest with you, everyone's gone. Everyone's left except for Ali Mullally. She's come up here and I think she might have something to say. The score, if you don't know it, if you don't know, you know. Brentford 1, Wolverhampton Wanderers 4. And it was just one hell of a catastrophic game that just didn't go right from the beginning to the end. If I'm going to ask you to what went wrong in that game, we'll probably be here until 2027. What was going on?
I think we created more chances for Wolves than we did for ourselves, didn't we? I think that was part of the problem. I don't know what was going on. There were a lot of individual errors at the back. We looked disjointed. We didn't look coherent as a unit. Midfield didn't look coherent as a unit. The defence, Nathan Collins had an absolute nightmare. We basically gifted them 4 goals. We did create some stuff, but Lewis Potter gets 3. I think he gets the ball across 3 times. There's nobody gambling in there to get on the end of that. And you have to feel that if Tony was there, he would have had a couple of goals in that first 10, 15 minutes, first half. And then, yeah, I think it's really, we've got to pick ourselves up from that. And I think we can pick ourselves up from that. But, yeah, it was not a good end to Christmas, was it? Really?
And the players are walking around and you can see this has been a tough one for them because they, listen, they cut the fans, win, lose or draw. We've been battered here, 4-1 by Wolves on our own turf. We've embarrassed ourselves. We've made some really ridiculous mistakes. And then the players have had to walk around and, you know, and pay respect to the fans. And that must be really tough. You can see it on their faces. This is tough. You see Jensen's walking past going, I just want to get the dressing room.
Yeah, but it'd be fair to Jensen. I don't think any of that was down to him, but he wasn't on the pitch long enough. And he doesn't look like he looks a bit unwell to me. But to be fair, when you put in a performance like that, you have to suck up doing the difficult thing and walk around and applaud the fans. You've just got to suck that up after that sort of performance. It's the worst performance I've seen in a long time by us. I know the injuries are killing us. I think we have to go 3 at the back because I don't think it's fair to expose players who aren't fullbacks to being fullbacks. They can cope with being wingbacks. I think the Mee suspension makes a massive difference today. I think if we'd had 3, be able to play that 3, might not have been quite so shambolic at the back. But, you know, we dust ourselves off and we go again on Saturday and hopefully we can get something out of Palace. We're going to have to be a hell of a lot better than we were today.
Dusting ourselves off is what we feel that we need to do. I tell you something, there's a bit of a dusting off going on here on the pitch here today because it's really bad because it's one of those ones where it's that game where we were like, you know, behind and we were a bit behind, but we still felt that everyone was inside here thinking we can get something. I'm looking at the clock, it's 70 minutes and the fans still felt they could get something out of it. It was a bit of a weird one, wasn't it? Like, you know, because it's almost like we'd made some stupid mistakes, let in some stupid goals, but all of a sudden we just thought, actually, we can get in there. But what was annoying, we kept getting the ball up. And listen, I love Neil Maupay, but Neil Maupay today wasn't on the money at all. He was losing the ball. He wasn't anticipating the play. And it was, and I hate saying like playing like 10 men, but it was like, it wasn't what we needed up front today as well.
No, it's very disappointing, Bill. I think my biggest frustration about today, we were so good against Villa and we were so threatening. And as you say, when we always felt that we could come back into it, and yet the final ball was delivered into areas and the two attackers, Whistler to an extent as well. But yeah, Neil was just on a different wavelength today. Clearly not what we need. I think others suggested it. We've got no pace there at the moment. So I don't know what to say. But the biggest frustration for me, we were so poor against today and we were so good against Villa. It was just a catalogue of errors. I don't know if Collins was 100%, ankle was warming up from
Agent Collins. Is it Agent Collins, was that?
Yeah, it was practically, it was very much Agent Collins. But was ankle warming up because he wasn't 100%? the squad is just so paper thin, and we're putting, you know, tip my hat to Yarmolook. He competed out there, but he got hooked at half time.
Yarmolook.
Yeah, exactly. Because there is the alternatives there at that moment, Bill. It's going to be so interesting to see what happens for the Forest game, because do things open up? Does Ivor move on?
The Forest game, that's a month away, that is.
Unfortunately, there's only two games there.
It's only one league game away, though.
Yeah, it's one league game, but it'd be interesting to see where do we go with Flecken as well now. You know, does Shroska get his chance against Palace, or does he get it against Forest, against Wolves?
So just saying that, because there were two real big fluffs, and both of them, I think, were down to... we had Collins, who there was some sort of kind of playing the ball out from the back, a nonsense back pass thing, and then the opposition got the ball and played the ball in the back of the net. Do you think it was goalkeeper's fault? Do you think it was the defender's fault? Or was it just an all-over fluff?
Well, I think you've got to clearly have the roots... the ball out, and you've got to have plenty of alternatives if you're going to play the ball like that. It's funny watching the Forest game yesterday, with Forest coming here, the next league game at home. You sort of think to yourself, you'd want to be closing those down, and that's exactly what Wolves done, and they took two opportunities from that by just closing the stand, not letting us play the ball out. Sometimes you need to mix it up. I don't know, Bill, there's smarter guys around me within this group that will pass comment on this, but there is... We were the architects of our own downfall on a number of levels today, and that's where I'm frustrated. You know, in this league, you're going to come up against quality without giving people the head start here. You know, is there something underlying going on here as well? You know, that's the bit that would worry me. If there's something underlying going on, I would hope that Matthew would address it quite quickly. He has in the past, but let's see. Who knows, Bill? It's a hard one to take.
You bees. We've got bees in the house here as well. We're not in the house, we're in the park, actually. We were in the park, in the dark, in the park, because we thought if we get in the park, in the dark, then we can actually kind of just take away the kind of negative vibes that we had in the stadium there. Yeah. And we can actually kind of contemplate some positivity and try and get some positivity out of that game. Have you got any positivity out of that game, Dave?
I thought that Keane Lewis Potter had a really good game. I thought he looked dangerous. Best game I've seen him play this season, I think. I think obviously getting more games is giving him more confidence. So he's a big plus.
Yeah, he is, and just to say what you said, and we comment on this, we're saying that he's a player. You can see he beats the player, crosses the ball in, puts the ball in, and there's no one in the middle Absolutely. To actually get it. And yeah. We're saying that he's the kind of player that needs positivity. He needs positivity around him. The more that he gets that, and it's almost like he needs around him somebody who's going to go, Keane, come on, Keane, you can do this, and actually big him up a little bit, you know what I'm saying? And I don't know whether or not those players are on the pitch today, whereas, you know, you've got sort of kind of second-string players in and around him.
Yeah.
And so he's kind of trying to be the lead man himself, but maybe he needs a bigger player in around him to say, yes, Keane, that's it, you put the ball in for me, boom. Whether or not that's Tony, whoever else it may be.
Well, hopefully it'd be Tony, but who knows what... I'd like to think Ivan would think, you know, to stay with us until the end of the season. We all know that he wants to go to another club, which is fair dues, he deserves that. Hopefully he feels that he can... doesn't have to go in January. That would be like a new signing for us. I thought Wissa had a good game today. First half particularly looked dangerous two or three times. I think he faded second half. Neil does his usual 100%, but I just think sometimes he's a little bit lacking in that. Unless it's like a tap-in or something like that. His approach play is good, but he's not really going to score you 10 goals a season, I think. And I think that's probably what Brighton and Everton found out. But you know, he makes the team, he tries. You can't fault him or any of the players for their effort today. I thought they were all excellent. Salmon had a good game. Christian played well. Pinnock again. I feel for Nathan Collins. I mean, who wants to do that sort of thing, you know, twice, give the ball away, really.
Give the ball away and the opposition score a goal, you mean?
Yeah, I think it was him, unless I got that wrong. I feel for him big time. I mean, no, he doesn't do that on purpose. It's one of those things. He's got to be strong and bounce back and be strong at Palace. I remember we went to Newcastle a few years ago and Ethan had a bad game, I think. Did he score an own goal and gave the ball away? We lost 5-1.
Got smashed up. We got smashed up there.
And I remember some of the commentators were saying, you know, he's the worst player to play in the Premier League. And since then, he's been absolutely fantastic. Hopefully, Nathan will do the same. Come back stronger, better. I feel for him tonight because I think, you know, he obviously wanted to do well against his old club. And it didn't happen tonight.
You bees.
You bees.
So back in the Globe and, it's a little bit... It's not the post-Christmas celebration that we were all expecting. All I can say is that it was a good thing that we did the kick all out of football. We went to Richmond, to the old Ted Lasso pub, the Princess Head, which is called something else than Ted Lasso. I can't even remember what it's called. All you Americans, you'll probably know. Went there with Paul Buckle, the old Brentford, ex-Brentford player there with all his American posse. And we met them there at lunchtime. And we had a right good drink and a right good chat and a right good laugh. And to be quite honest with you, thank Christ we actually kind of did a kick football and had a bit of a good day out before we actually got to the game today, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a tough old watch. My eyes hurt, my voice hurts. I've been trying to get behind the team. But as soon as I saw the lineup, the starting 11, I just thought, we're really are scraping it now. I thought we were going to get Jensen back to start and Damsgaard. We thought that they were going to be in midfield. They were on the bench. They came on, but the game was all over and done with, really. And we did all right in large parts. We just shot ourselves in the foot. You know, we made calamitous mistakes. Collins and Flecken and the obligatory far post header from a cross or a corner when someone goes in unmarked and just heads home at the far stick. You know, we had ourselves to blame for conceding. Wiese, bless his heart, he pulled one back when we were 2-0 down. Goal exactly when we needed one, but we weren't anywhere near strong enough to compete in the Premier League. Really, you know, we did all right in parts and we had decent possession, but you know, we desperately need players coming back in. You know, our missing injured stars. And we need January transfer window to strengthen in a couple of places. There's question marks all over that pitch tonight, but can't really blame many of them because they're all playing out of position. And they're you know, that wasn't our preferred starting lineup. Maybe three or four of them we would be in the starting lineup, but probably not in the positions they played tonight. So you know, I'm going to cut them some slack, but it was a really brutally hard watch, and we caused all our own problems, Bill.
Caused a lot of problems. Besotted Pride of West London podcast. But it's a bit of besotted.com/beer. You can see we sound a bit exasperated.
Listen, we're going to Palace.
Yeah, we're going to go to Palace in a couple of days' time. Like I said to you, we got a nice little drinking hole in Palace. Like I say, I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to be in the South Coast. I'm going to be in Brighton for the next week. So I'm looking forward to coming up to Palace from Brighton, because obviously Palace hate Brighton and Brighton hate Palace, which is all good. But this is the Presided Pride of West London podcast. We didn't beat Wolves. We got smashed by Wolves. We completely fluffed it, but it doesn't matter. We'll move on. We're not getting relegated as far as I'm concerned. I know a lot of people are very, very nervous about that, but don't you worry about it. We'll get back in the new year. The main game is Forest. Let's focus on the Forest game. That's when everyone's coming back, all guns blazing. Let's do Forest. We're going to absolutely do them. Don't worry about any of the game.
Come on, you bees.